Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Might and Magic, the World of Xeen. As per usual, we're just going to go ahead and jump on in here. Where we last left off, we were clearing out cities and fighting with the damn copy protection every episode. Because reasons. So I think this was, what, Lakeside? Yeah, I remembered. The City of Hags. Quite obnoxious. So let's kind of clear it out. It shouldn't really be a problem. Honestly, not worried. Get my mouse cursor out of here. Get it back in the bottom right corner where it belongs. Unprompted, the skull begins to speak. To make a potion of personality, gather together the ground horn of a unicorn, the tan hide of an ogre, and the blood of a monkey dog sacrificed neath the blackness of a new moon. Slowly pour a half part of the blood into a 20-gallon cauldron and mix in the horn powder. Heat to a low simmer and let sit for 3 days. At the stroke of midnight on the third night, drop the ogre hide into the stew and stir rapidly. The hide should dissolve into the caustic brew in 3 minutes. Exactly. If the hide dissolves any sooner or any later, the brew is sour and will turn its drinkers to stone. Makes one serving. Okay. The cozy little tavern. These stairs once led to a tavern, but it was destroyed long ago. Gonna find some scrolls under the bed there. Anything good? I think that's under miscellaneous. Fiery flails, town portals, and dancing scroll, or dancing swords. I'm gonna give the town portal scroll to Brunhilde, actually, because she has the highest amount of health in the party. Aside from that, nothing too interesting. Actually, see, she has raised it. I'm gonna give this raising dead gem to Devon, because now Swell can actually cast raise dead. So that actually makes, I think, like, 5 of 6 members of our party able to raise the dead. That is helpful.
Thank you for saving me. I'm tired of adventuring and I'm going home, but I can tell you that the dragon statuette is in the sewer below us. The witches caught me just as I was reaching for it. Maybe you'll have better luck than me.
Really? Well, that's handy to know. Let's continue poking around. The smithy! Again, destroyed long ago, sadly. Oh god. Make a potion of endurance, gather together the poison entrails of a toad kept under a cold stone for 31 days, and slice of a swamp snake. The eye of a newt, the toe of a frog, wool from a bat, and tongue of a dog. A lizard's leg, an owlet's wing, and the forked tongue of a snake. Throw them all in the cauldron and let sit under the auspices of the full moon. Begin boiling just before sunrise. Keep warm until sunrise of the next day. The mixture turns black, the brew is sour, and will turn its drinkers to stone. Makes one serving.
Okay.
Well, we have a back area here, which... I don't even think they can hurt us past our resistances. Yeah. We've kind of got these things. We're here at a much later point in the game than we should have been. Like, we should have come through this before the Isle of Lost Souls, but I just, like, brain farted on where the key was. My fault. Necropolis, I think, will be harder for us. 10,000 gold and 100 gems. And I'm gonna guess this is, yeah, an empty cage. Cauldron, not gonna worry about it. Oh, this is okay, this is their leader. So, I'm gonna say chunk one-shots her. Yeah, that's about right.
Oh, thank you for rescuing me. The witches were going to use me for spare parts in their potions.
Okay. Another 200,000 experience. That's what I think, like 300,000 or 600,000 experience points we've earned thus far. And I passed the necropolis. Awesome. And then 36,000 gold and a bunch of charms. Let's see what we've got here. I think those are accessories. Yes, Thunder Charm and a Gold Charm, so both of which are useless to me. At least for now. So we do have a way underground, but we also have this. A bodiless voice murmurs, "You are the most beautiful one of all." What a twist. Get out of here. You are of no threat to me, but I will take your gems all the same.
Thank you for saving me from my hideous fate. I am forever in your debt. I'll be going now.
Wow, Isabella. You really couldn't have been any less interested there.
My saviors. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. The witches were were going to turn me into a monster when I failed the initiation test. I didn't know they did that to people. Because they did this to me, I'll tell you where the head witch keeps her pass to Necropolis. It is in a chest in her room in the northwestern corner of the town.
Well, thanks for that. I mean, we totally needed that because we haven't already Oh. We found lakeside yachts here, which if I recall correctly, you can actually take one of these boats somewhere. I don't remember where. This boat under repair. 10,000 gold, nothing there. Let's see here. Yeah, passage to the Isle of Lost Souls for, like, the people that, I guess, can't make it there otherwise. I don't know. If you can get to that boat, you should be able to, I think, get the aisle. Anyways. So we're in the sewers. Go ahead and search the bones. I'm not expecting to find any of the bones. Oh, hey, random sewer stalkers. So we know the dragon statuette is down here, which we need. For what? I honestly don't recall. Naturally, knowing that it's down here, I want it. Set it right there. Golden dragon statuette. Well, that was easy. I suppose in theory I could explore this place, but I don't seem to recall there really being anything too valuable down here. I do like the music in the, like, the sewer areas in this. It's very... I don't know, it's low-key, but not unpleasant.
Knowing how to pray properly can certainly come in handy when the going gets tough. I can teach you for 10,000 gold.
Prayer Master, I think... She's got it. I think this might up your spell points. Yeah, so he picked up 40 extra spell points from that. Not too crazy, but I guess it's better than nothing. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and get out of here. Hey, other town music. Okay, and... See, we're at 76,000 gold, so we're in a town portal back to Castleview. I'm gonna deposit it.
Got a pass. Okay, go ahead.
And, let's see here. I always forget where the bank is. Yeah, that's not the bank. Right here. There we are.
It'll be safe.
Deposit. Gold. We'll go with 75,000. And I've got 3,400 gems, which I don't think I really need quite that many. I will deposit 14. I'll deposit 2,400 of them. Not too worried. And we can just go ahead and sleep here. Have everybody rebuff. And town portal to Necropolis. And I'm gonna save. Yes, 26, okay.
Got a pass?
Yep.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, so as you can see, Necropolis is like, oh hey, welcome. We're gonna just attempt to murder you right off the bat. Aw, oh, man, I would have been impressed if Rove could have one-shot one of those, but I'm pretty sure he's still got, like, a crappy... Well, he might have an obsidian. No, just a radiating staff. See, I can't remember. Alright, now these books... These books are dangerous. Alright, this is a boss fight right here.
I am Sunro, the most accomplished sorcerer to ever live in Xeen. Many years ago, I separated my heart from my body in a magical ritual devised to cheat death. It worked, but I am not wholly alive. Rather, I am a wretched and evil monster who must kill mortals to remain alive. If you can retrieve my heart from the sewers below, I will finally be released from this unlife, and you may have the statuette sitting in the alcove in my room. And now, my hunger for the living compels me to attack you!
Okay, so, this isn't the only time we'll be fighting Xander. Oh, and of course, everyone else in the party's like, good joke, Xander, and Rove's like, living up to his namesake. We're just gonna go ahead and res his... Oh wait, no, that's... Damn it, I accidentally cast Resurrect instead of Raise Dead. Resurrect is Eradication. Damn it, Rove. And we will power cure him. Should only take one or two, I would think. Yeah. Would you like to buy membership to the guild for 50,000 gold? No. We do not need that. Don't even think about taking my statuette. Now, if we were to, we can actually use this again and fight him again. I don't know if he's worth experience every time. So we've got the Books of the Dead, which, if I recall correctly, I think these things, like, super age you. Yeah, 25 years and 999,000 experience points. Now, the trick to these is your characters, as far as I'm aware, can theoretically be, like, infinitely old and it won't kill them until, like, the next day. So, what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna read all of these, and then we're going to go and hit the Fountain of Youth really quick. And that will kind of allow us to bypass the 100 years that everybody's gonna be eating up here. Let's see, so it shouldn't kill us to read from all of these. As you can see, we're getting kind of geriatric, though. The experience killed you. Oh, okay. So none of that. So Ray's dead. So I think it was Devon's Lloyd's Beacon. No. Then it was Rose. I know we have a Lloyd's Beacon sat right at the... Or maybe I'm just being stupid and didn't set one. I thought I had, but apparently I changed my mind and elected instead to force myself into running there. Well, that's not good. Wonder why I did that. I'm sure I had a reason for it, and it seemed like a good one at the time. But, I don't know. Okay. So as you can see, now all of our ages are back down to normal, and we've earned basically 3 million experience points. Not a bad deal. Go ahead and head back.
Got a pass? Okay, go ahead.
Now, let's see. I'm gonna save before I do this that way. Well, actually, you know what? Here, I'll just have Roe do it. Alright, so you can, in fact, age to death from these things. I did not know that. Okay, so now everybody's in their 50s. I actually don't particularly care. I don't think it's really gonna do too much. So I'm just going to rebuff. And we will continue onward. New day of sorcery. And into the town we go. More higher mummies, not particularly worth anything. I think that's a mega lich, or a power lich rather. Okay, and we have the Well of Death, and both of the heads are like, dude, don't, just don't. Oh look, it's more Books of the Dead. It's like the game knew. Alright, there's the guild. Not too interested in that. Go ahead and just murder these things. Again, this is somewhere that we should have probably come at a slightly lower level than we are right now, but we didn't, so we're gonna have a much easier time of it. Oh, damn it, people are asleep. I didn't even notice that. Go ahead and awaken. Nothing here. We'll just start cracking these things open. Won't budge, too weak. Brunhilde, really? Swell? No, wow. Strength scores of 100 and they can't open these things. Man, fighter types, I am disappointed in you. Okay, so we have two more Books of the Dead there. We have more coffins that I'm gonna go ahead and assume that I can't open. And Book of the Dead. And more Books of the Dead. And more mummies, which again, I'm not too particularly worried about. There is one skull in here that tells a story that is very, very long that I'm actually going to just... I'm not going to read it to you guys. If you want to read it, you're going to have to pause the video because it is very long. And it's this one right here. So what I'm going to do is kind of just like wait here for, I don't know, 5 seconds on each one, and you can, like I said, pause the video and have at it yourself. Okay, so that is that. It's a story that I think personally, there are, I believe, a number of ways you can interpret it. My personal belief is that it's pertaining to Sheltum and... God, what's his name? Korak. Not Korak. Oh, not smart enough to decipher the words of this book. As you can see, that one aged Rove 50 years instead. So, yeah, this is where the experience points are going to start diverging, because I believe from this point on, nobody's going to be able to read them except for Rove. So, yeah, he's going to be having some levels on him compared to everybody else. And this is where I mentioned that, like, at the end of the game, he was going to be the most powerful person in the party. This is one of the reasons for that. Because they lock a lot of bonus experience points behind having a really high intelligence score. And obviously, he's going to be the only one that has that. Okay, so I'm going to actually go ahead and just set this thing here, because we're going to be making at least one more, if not more, returns back here. I'd say it's actually probably going to be...
Okay.
Well, if they're 50 years apiece, a couple passes for each of them. All right, so he already read book 6. So book... Oh, no, that's book 5. Did he already read that? Yes. I read that. 8. I need 7. That's 9. 100 years and 9,999,000 experience points. There you go. Rove, in doing that, has earned more experience than our other party members have. Well, not really, but substantial amount of experience points. Okay, and the only downside of this is that we've got to watch that stupid muscle bro kind of extol his gatekeeper duty every time we walk in. I'd drop another, like, Lloyd's Beacon or something, but meh. Okay, 50 years, 50 years. Okay, that is all of them. So Rove is ancient and he's sitting on, like, what is that? Wow. So Chunk's at the least, so he's sitting on almost 20 million experience points more than Chunk is right now. Welcome to game balance. I got nothing. All right, so we'll go ahead and do that. Go ahead and town portal back one last time, and it's time to go to the sewers. We'll get Sandro's heart, and then we will murder him again, and that will be it for here, I believe. And then I'm probably going to have to do leveling, I think. Well, maybe not. We'll see. All in a day, of course, rolls over. All right, we'll go ahead and sleep then. Day of sorcery, we will day of protection, and now I will have to find that damn this. Alright, descend into the sewers, and the floor is lava. Kind of troublesome, but with teleportation, less so. And, wrong number, it's 3, I think. There we go. Box. It's like I knew! Yeah, I'm not gonna play that bullshit. Sorry, folks. If you were expecting me to be, like, trudging around in there, not gonna happen. Day of sorcery, day of protection.
Thank you for returning my heart. I am free of this unlife. You are welcome to the treasures in this room, as well as this key. It opens the way to my old home on the other side of the world, a place now called the Dungeon of Death. You are welcome to the treasures hidden there as well. Goodbye, brave mortals, and good luck. Remember, Alamar can be defeated.
Alright, another 2 million experience points. And the key to the Dungeon of Death, which is the crossword puzzle dungeon. The statue, the golden griffin. Okay. Actually, wrong button. I want to check. I think it's this. Items. Okay, so we have a golden dragon, golden griffin, and I think that's about it. Yeah. I want to check. And. Alright. So we can go out now and. Thinking on it, like, I'm thinking where we should go, because after that, like, we're, I think pretty much going to have to go do training. So I'm going to town portal us to Castle View. And we're going to go and spend a lot of time. I don't know how many years I'm going to do this for. But it's guaranteed that it's not going to be like 3. It's a good thing that they don't have you on a time limit here, because I'm pretty sure the game would be much more challenging if they did. Okay, wait for this to sort itself out. Town Portal 2, River City. Okay, and I've got 1,000 gold on me, so I don't particularly care. And everyone is 29.
I'll give you 100.
So here we go, high action gameplay right here. So I'm gonna do this for like 5 minutes. This is it. This is what you do, because there's no other reliable way to earn a decent amount of money in this game. At least what they require you to reach the levels you're expected to be to like finish the game. I'm probably gonna. I want to say the level cap in. Well, I can't remember what the level cap is on. God, I can't even remember the name of the city. Not Night Shadow. The second city, Sandcaster. There we go. I can't even remember what the level cap is for the training there, but that's the only training area we'll have until we get to Olympus, which has no cap to its training area. I want to say it's like 50. So if that's the case, we're going to probably be topping off pretty soon.
I'll give you a...
Like I said, folks, high action adventure here. So we're at 37. I'm going to go to 40 and we'll see how we're looking on money. Now, in my other Let's Play, I did this much earlier in the game, so I'm probably going to have a substantially larger amount of money this time than I did the other, like, my other run. Should be about there. Yep, okay. So let's pull out of here and go this way. So we went from 1,000 gold to 12,000 gold, so there you go. Alright, we're at 15 million gold, so we're gonna go ahead and withdraw gold 5 million. And we've got 207,000 gems, which, don't really particularly care too much about that. So I'm gonna go to Vertigo, and we can just walk outside. This copy protection. Okay. Town portal again to Sandcaster. Let's see how this goes.
Okay. Go ahead.
I am certain that this is probably not gonna be enough money to cap everybody in the party here.
You
maybe. We'll see. I wanna see how high they go. Is it 50? Yes. Okay. So 50th level for everyone across the board here. Well, hey, you know, that only cost us 2 million gold pieces. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to Sandcastle, and I'm just going to immediately redeposit all of this money because I don't want to be running around with 3 million gold pieces. 3,800,000, specifically. So it was really only like 1.2 million. Still a substantial amount of money. Deposit gold, 3,500,000. Deposit gold, 319,000. Alright. So yeah, and we're only in our 40s. That is kind of emboldening. I am gonna save. And everybody's looking a little bit beef here now. Even Rove's sitting at 650 hit points there. So we're gonna sleep. And let's see what time is it. 10 a.m.? Alright. Go ahead and Lloyd's Beacon. Use this. And Day of Protection, and Day of Sorcery, and Map. Okay, so I need to... I wish they gave you, like, a larger map, because I don't remember exactly where the Dragon Pharaoh's pyramid is, but it looks like it's right here. So I'm thankful. And we're gonna try this again. I'm unsure as to whether even, like, with all this stuff, if we're ready, but we basically have to be, because I don't think we can do any more leveling until we've completed this place. Okay. Jesus. I don't know if he can cast spells through doors. We're gonna find out. Well, I didn't eat anything on the return, so I assume it worked. Oh, Rove, you just screwed yourself there. Oh, Rove, what have you done? And there goes the party. Wow. Yeah. Like, this is... It's not so much that it's, like, super difficult, it's just that you have to get into melee with them as quickly as possible. So I actually think I'm gonna do here is... teleport. Oh, and of course they have teleportation magic blocked. God, these things just have so much health. Oh, and I did not mean to step forward there. We're gonna sleep. Like, the 15 levels I don't think are going to help us as much as I would hope. So, Day of Sorcery, Day of Protection, what are our resistances looking like here? Cold of 7. I'm gonna go ahead and cast Protection from Elements. What does that bump it up to? Still 7, like, I don't get it. Unless... I don't know. Here, let me see if that's, like... maybe... cold. Maybe it just doesn't count. Like, I know that that's what these four corners are, is your elemental resistances, and I think Day of Protection flips all of those on. Yeah. So, like, that's what we've got. Okay, so we've killed one of them. Excuse me. I apologize for clearing my throat so much here. I want to check... let's see, we can't teleport. Can we jump? We can jump. That... makes things a little bit better. Oh, and there's a fire dragon back there, too. Wow. Oh, man. I'm stupid. I should have just had Swell Divine Intervention the entire party there. That was deathborn of stupidity. We'll try this again. Okay, I know I can jump now. So do that. Everybody's gonna... oh, and of course Swell goes down this time. Because reasons. Okay. I'm trying to think of, like, strategery here. So they should be following me. In theory. I'm gonna shoot once. No. Alright, now they're gonna be following me. Or maybe not. Seriously? Alright. Damn it, Rove, of course you had to go down. Let's see, if I move forward one, they're gonna move forward one, breathe on me, and attack twice. We'll try it. Wow. It's nasty. And this, like I said, you don't really need resistances until, like, the end of the end of the game. And, like, outside of this, you really don't need them too much past this area. So there they are. Now they're on me. Go back. Do some damage. Swell. Divine Intervene. Rove. I want you to jump us. Okay, seriously? Like, what was that? Jump failed. Ugh. I'm trying to think here. Maybe I can... we'll just starburst them. I was gonna say, I'm sure it won't kill them, but... did it squishy them enough? No. Dang, I was hoping that that would at least do enough damage to render them to the point where I could arrow them down, which is apparently not gonna be the case. Alright. I'm gonna have to be kind of unorthodox here. I don't know. I think my best bet is actually probably just, like, casting Dragon Sleep and hoping it works. Honestly. Because I don't think Goldleaf really has anything beyond, like, Mass Distortion. Not really. I don't know. Damn it, I did not mean to back up there. That was a poor choice on my part. Do divine intervention. Like, we'd have a chance if they didn't get attacks on us, like, immediately after we move forward here. See, he does not have enough for another divine intervention, so I'm just gonna melee. Alright, so that's two of them, and we're at 30 minutes. I'm gonna go, I think, a little bit over, like, maybe five more minutes or so. Not a lot, but just a little bit here, because, alright. Oh, and there are just a crap load of these guys in here. I see at least, like, four of them. Oof. Alright, we'll try jumping, see how bad these guys are. They're not doing as much damage. Notably less damage. Yeah, okay, so we've got those guys. What do we have here? The statue that speaks as you approach. Built during the creation, the Royal Dragon Pyramid has stood the test of time. Visitors have been flocking to see the great monument. That looks like it's spelled wrong, but I don't think it is. Since it was opened to the public 312 years ago, there's much to see and explore in the pyramid, so be sure to check the information desk for the latest tour, information, and don't forget to stop at the Royal Bookstore for Crackle Hiss, built during the creation. Alright, pull the lever. Wrong lever! I know I made that joke like three episodes ago, I don't care. Okay, so we've cleared that. I'm gonna, I think, save. I think I already saved, but I'm doing it again just to make sure because I'm stupid enough to forget. Okay, so this was number puzzles, which I'm not in the mood for at the moment because I don't brain good. Oh, this is gonna end poorly. Ah, if that second one hadn't attacked, I was gonna divine intervention my party back up and we would have probably been able to kill them, but alas. Things didn't work out quite that well for me. Okay, round two. Can I jump from here? No. And of course the game's like, we're gonna screw you anyways. Because, dickery. Alright, I think we might have this. Maybe. Probably not. Ugh. No. It's terrible. Just terrible. I do remember having some, I wouldn't say like major issues with this place the first time I came through, but I do remember it being, you know, pretty challenging. Just trying to think of how we can go about this in such a way that isn't going to get me completely pasted here. I have Gold Leaf cast a divine intervention this time. Never cast another one. See, I'm gonna keep casting it until they get into melee with me. Because I'm gonna need to cast one from Swell there. Alright, so now we can melee these two down. I love it, I'm like aging my people here, but it's not permanent aging, so I don't particularly care since we have the fountain of no more age. Alright, so that was the easy room. Let's see what we've got in here. Oh, is it just like a fire dragon? Oh no, there's more of them back there. Maybe, yeah, just two of them. I'm almost tempted. I was gonna say, I'm almost tempted to just range this thing down, but that probably wouldn't work too well. I'm gonna come up this way. All right, another lever. Go ahead and pull that. Well, that's two. I think the next one's all gonna be number puzzle based, because I don't think we're gonna be able to just go up these stairs. So did I pull this one? Did now. Can I go up? No. Okay, well, we're at 33 minutes, and this number puzzle is actually probably, I'm not even gonna lie to you guys, I'm probably gonna do it off screen simply because it's gonna take me probably longer than it should because I can be dumb sometimes. Well, here's another lever that I missed, actually. I don't know how many levers there are. We'll see if this one did it. Maybe it did. Maybe we just got lucky. I'm not hopeful, but never know. No. Okay, so I'm gonna call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will catch you all next time with a solved number puzzle and all that good jazz. Until then, take it easy.